At the end of the topic, you will be able to explain the policy adopted by Lord William Bentinck in India, describe the reforms of Lord William Bentinck, discuss the Charter Act of 1833. Lord Amherst succeeded Lord Hastings, and in his era, the Burmese tried to capture Assam. Therefore, in 1824, Lord Amherst declared war on Burma, known as the First Burmese War. With the Treaty of Yandabu in 1826, the war ended. The English got Arakan and Tenasserim. Lord William Bentinck succeeded Lord Amherst and followed a policy of non-interference with regard to Indian states. His reforms made him popular, and he was also considered to be one of the greatest governor-generals of India. Lord William Bentinck reduced the salaries of the civil servants to raise the finance of the East India Company. Several Indians were employed on low salaries. He also controlled the opium trade. The bata or allowance of the military officers of the company was reduced by him. Lord William Bentinck eliminated the provincial courts of appeal. He established a Sadar Diwani Adalat or civil court and a Sadar Nizamat Adalat or criminal court in Allahabad. Lord William Bentinck joined the office of the collector with the magistrate. He was in charge as the commander-in-chief of the army and declared several reforms. He announced vernacular language as the court language in the place of the Persian language. The Charter Act of 1833 created a new post of law member in the Executive Council of the Governor-General. Lord Macaulay was the first law member. Social reforms, abolition of sati, female infanticide, and suppression of thugs.
Sati was an age-old custom where the women sat on the funeral pyre of a husband and burnt herself to death. Committing sati was considered an honor to the family. Raja Ram Mohan Roy started an agitation against this, and he was supported by Bentinck, who soon declared sati an illegal and punishable offence by the Regulation 17 of 1829. Lord Bentinck also passed an act which declared the killing of infant girls a punishable offence. Thugs were banned of murderers and robbers who committed serious crimes in many parts of India. Many thugs operated in parts of central India and made it difficult for travelers to travel safely. Bentinck put an end to this by hunting the thugs down with the special forces and incorporating severe punishments for them. Collectors were instructed to assess the produce and collect land revenue, which developed the economy of India.
Educational reforms.
Bentinck used the money allotted for education in promoting Western education through the medium of English. The Indian society suffered from many social evils like untouchability, caste system, female infanticide, and sati, and so on. Educated and liberated Indians and Englishmen began to make efforts to reform the society. Reformers like Raja Ram Mohan Roy, Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar, and Lord Bentinck tried to put an end to many of these evils.
The Charter Act of 1833. The Charter Act of 1833 was passed during the period of Lord William Bentinck. As a result, monopoly of the company was abolished and the Governor-General of Bengal became the Governor-General of India. This act added a law member to the Executive Council of the Governor-General. For the benefit of Christians in India, bishops were appointed in Bombay, Madras and Calcutta. Estimate: Lord William Bentinck passed many beneficial reforms in social, administrative, financial and judicial fields. He was compared with Lord Ripon for his compassionate approach towards the Indians. He did a lot for the welfare of the people, and English education was encouraged. In this topic, you have learned, Lord William Bentinck was considered as the great Governor-General of India due to his great reforms. Bentinck followed a policy of non-interference. He permitted the use of vernacular languages in the lower courts and introduced Western education. Bentinck declared sati and female infanticide as punishable offences. Monopoly of the company was abolished by the Charter Act of 1833.